If you don't have an audio interface, or maybe you do have one and it doesn't have an Asio driver, but you want to lower your latency, in this video I'm going to show you how Asio4All can help. I'm going to go through the installation and then I'll get into the setup and how to change the Asio4All settings in your DAW. I'm Zane, welcome to Audio Tech TV, where it's my goal to help you conquer the tech so you can unleash your creativity, and I do this by providing easy to follow audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews. Now, let's jump in. All right, so obviously the first thing you want to do is download Asio4All. So go to asio4all.org and download the language that you prefer. Now notice the latest version is only available in English, but you should be all right with these other versions if you need those. And also to note, when I click on this, nothing happens. So what I've had to do is right click and then open link in new tab. And then that brings the download window up. And then you can download it. And then once it's downloaded, launch the installer. And you'll have to accept the terms. And you'll see that there's a couple of options here. And the first one is for rewire support. If you need that, then check that off. And the second one, it says that it's useless over in the brackets there. So I'm not going to click that. I don't need either of these things, so I'm going to leave them both unchecked and then click next. You can choose where you want to install it to. I'm fine with the default location and click install. It's now installed. So now let's go into your DAW. All right, so for this, I'm just going to use FL Studio, but the basics are going to be pretty much the same for every DAW. You just want to go into your audio settings for whatever DAW you use. And you may have to change the driver type to Asio if it's not already there, or if it's like FL Studio, you could just click on device and then under Asio, you want to click on Asio4All. And if your DAW has a separate thing for driver type and device, you want to click Asio for driver type. And then in the device, you want Asio4All. And once you've done that, you'll be able to access the control panel here. And your DAW might call it just simply control panel or Asio control panel. It will be something along those lines. So you click on that. And this will look the same in every DAW because this is the Asio4All control panel. Now, if you're just using your built-in sound card and you don't have a USB audio interface, you're probably not going to have as many selections in here. So don't worry about that. What you want to do is find your built-in sound card. If it's not selected already, it probably will be if that's all you're using, but you want to click on this button here and make sure it's lit up like this. And now we want to click on this wrench right here. And then you can see there's a plus sign beside it. We'll click on that and make sure that the output is for the Realtek HD audio output. That's my built-in sound card. And then the input for mine is the stereo input. That's actually going to record whatever's coming through my computer, but I could change it to the mic in the front or the mic in the rear or the line input, whatever I want. I'm actually going to switch it to the mic in the front. And you can see we can have multiple things, but I'm going to take this off and just have these two things. So it's going to output to my built-in sound card speakers. So if you were on a laptop, it would be your laptop speakers or your headphones. And on a desktop, it's going to be either your headphones or if you have any speakers connected to it. And then for the input, I'm using the mic in the front panel. And that's pretty much it for now. So the way I have it set up right here, like I said, is just for using your built-in sound card. But if you have an audio interface and you want to set this up kind of different, you want the input on your audio interface, but you want the output on your built-in sound card. So you want to connect your microphone to your audio interface, but you still want to hear the headphones connected to your laptop or your computer, or you want the output to go through your laptop speakers, then we would disable the mic input here and we'll still keep the output on the speakers. But now we'll go to my audio interface, which is the Audient ID 44. I'll click on that. And I want to disable the output. I want input 1 and 2 enabled. So you can see that's all I have enabled for that is the input. And then for here, I have the output. So now I could connect a microphone or a guitar to my audio interface. And then the audio is going to output to my computer speakers, whatever they are, or the headphone jack, whatever I have connected for that. Or if you just wanted to use it as the driver for your audio interface, again, you would set it up the same way we set up the built-in sound card. Now I'm going to turn off the ID44 input and I'm just going to set it up with the output here and the mic at the front. And this is a great setup if you're going to be connecting a mixer to your computer without an audio interface. And I have a video on that in case you want to check it out. I'll link to it down in the description. But you'll see over here and down here, we have some other options. And to start with, I would just leave these at the default settings. The one thing you may want to change eventually is this buffer size here. So you would just close this down, open up a project, see how the latency is when you're recording or whatever it is you're doing. And if the latency is too much, you'll want to reduce the size of the buffer. And this is going to lower the latency, but not all sound cards and computers are going to be able to handle the lowest buffer settings. So you want to play around with this to see what works best for your computer. So if you do end up lowering it and then you start hearing some clicks and pops and maybe even some audio dropouts, then you're going to want to increase that buffer size again. But if you lower it, you're not experiencing any issues, then you're good with that lower setting. So just play around with it on your computer. Again, try it at the default settings and see how it works. If it works great that way, then you're fine. Just leave it like that. Now, if you want to check out that video about connecting your mixer to your computer without an audio interface, click up here or click down here to see what YouTube recommends. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching for Audio Tech TV. I'm Zane. Keep creating and we'll talk soon.